what we started doing, we would do battle of the bands. Because in Pittsburgh, back in the day, there was a band here, there was a band across the street, there was a band over there, there was a band down the way. So we got out there, man. First one we did, I was so scared, man. They had a nickname for me. They called me Popsicle. Because all I did was looked at my damn feet. I didn't move. I didn't move. I didn't look at the audience. I was scared to death. I was scared to death. So I'm just sitting there with the bass. I weighed about a buck 10. So all I got is big old fro feet, and that's it. You know what I'm saying? And we shouldn't be doo 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 doo. So we was playing one of them joints, man. And so we got our butt kicked, right? Bands end up like smoking us. So we went back to the shed. We started getting on some different things, learning how to play some changes, getting the technical skills up and stuff like that. And then people start seeing us, man. And we started getting gigs because people say, I want them cats. So it wasn't like we went out and promoted ourselves. They wanted us. And we ended up doing pretty well, man. We played, like, first of all, started off playing like proms, after proms. And the drummer that we play with, man, colorful dude, man. This cat, his dad was a numbers runner. So he had a nice little crib. And he was a gangster, but he wasn't a violent dude. He just ran the numbers. So we had a place that we can go practice all the time. So we go practice all the time. And as we got better and better, we started playing. He had a place called the Coney Island, man. It's a little, we call it a shotgun bar, which is like, okay, picture bar, bars over here, doors back here, long, just long stage right here. So it's basically shotgun. It's just like, you know what I'm saying? Exactly. So we get in this mud. We like 12, 13. He got free entertainment. He get us some hamburgers and $5. We was playing all night. So we was in this mud. And man, it used to be so funny because in the wintertime, the place be packed. So they got us on this cheap stage. No real ventilation or nothing. People be in there smoking and stuff. Smoke was like this thick. We have to lean down to see the people, man. Because it was like the smoke was so thick. It was bad. I'm sure I'm gonna die young, but it was that experience right there, man. So, but it was cool because the thing was, we got up there and we knew maybe 12 songs, but we knew that they weren't paying attention to us no way. So we just played them 12 songs. So it's like, let's play that one again. That was kicking. But it gave us an opportunity to really learn how to groove.
Yeah.
When you're doing music, you got to love the music, but you're trying to get girls. You know what I'm saying? So when you're up there on that stage, they're looking at you. So for us, man, we were really into the music, like, wholeheartedly and all that stuff, man. So it was really important for us to music first, and then everything else would come. But then, you know, when we later in life, when we started writing and stuff, you know, it was all, we incorporated that and all that stuff into the music. Yeah.
We wrote the sappiest love songs you have ever heard in your life.
And we would write some other stuff, man. It was crazy. And we would, for the most part, we was playing the top 40 stuff. We was murdering the top 40 stuff. I'm talking about that killing R&B. BT Express, Brass Construction, Commodores, all that stuff. And then we throw in our sappy love songs once in a while, something like that. And then we couldn't sing worth beans neither. So we still try to work on that one. But, you know, that's we started getting into the writing thing, man. Because, you know, later, we really had to get away from that if we were going to progress.